Thought about going for it, the right back, but realised there was a lot of space going to be left behind him. But Bacard goes over, but the referee allows Niger to go forward. Abbe hits his arm, I think. And it is going to be a Niger free kick.
Ghana giving away too many free kicks. And that could be costly. I think the referee did give this free kick, rather.
Yes, you may well be right, Ben. Maybe it was for the first one. I actually thought he was inclined to play the advantage, actually.
Just some push there.
No offside about it, and his arm hasn't gone in the air here, the referee. Direct free kick, implying that. Fire gone out a little bit for Francois Zahawi's men after that electrifying opening. Kaidu clear, but not finding an orange jersey. Frimpong. Kobina has the hit. Miss hit again, really, in all honesty. It's an easy stop this time for Issa.
Again, I thought he rushed in, hitting the ball there. Should have taken his time because Frimpong drifted wide. Just look for him.
Now Stephen Sarfo on the run. Looking a little bit laboured as he went back then was Dankwa. He's got a problem here.
Dankwa has been carrying this injury all throughout. And that is where I think it should be a problem for Niger. I thought it was going to go out in the match against Benin, but he kept playing with it. The reason he kept the ball out of play was because he felt the pain.
This is a concern for Niger. Looks like he felt it about a yard or two before he got on the ball there. Looks like he has run his race, I'm afraid.
Yeah, making some signals there to a Teco team. Perhaps he's been hoping he'll be substituted.
Well, he will know if he cannot continue.
Well, Kofi Dankwa was part of the Nigerian team at the 2013 Nations Cup in South Africa. I do remember Ghana played Niger as well. He did play a part.
Is he actually feeling the other hamstring here, I think?
Maybe. Very strong player, Kofi Dankwa.
But hardly the ideal return to his former adopted homeland here in Ghana. That may well be the tournament-ending moment. Unlikely if it is a hamstring to shake that off in a day or two. Whatever the outcome to this semi-final. Here come Ghana! And it's gone in! And Ghana lead in the semi-final!
Guess what?
Kizito claims it!
Second goal of tournament, Kwame Kizito, the heart-to-foot striker. Sad story. Kofi Dankwa put the ball away so he could attend it to Kwame Ghana. Hit it wide, met this man. And Kizito simply giving Ghana hope.
So Niger undone, caught out at the corner. Nothing the goalkeeper could do about it. The injury to Dankwa. And in a sense, insult added to injury because the ball ended up in the net while they were down to 10. And look what it means all down the Cape Coast. Here it is again. They did miss their centre half.
Certainly. They were man down. Kizito met the ball so well and got it precisely into the net. I don't think the goalkeeper was actually impeded. He's making signals that yes, he was pushed down though, but I think Kizito met the ball rightly and that's it.
Hard luck stories all over the place for Niger here. but they don't count. What counts is that Kizito has given Ghana the lead from a set piece.
What I see happening for Niger is Ibrahim Hassan Mansour could come in there for Kofi Dankwa. Kofi can't continue, so he's out.
So they did not have their big stopper right where he was needed there, and Kizito got a free header as a result. How big a moment in this semi-final will it be? The player on the line did his best, Oda, but the goalkeeper was out of the equation. So Niger restart, but they do now have 11 men on the field again.
Good goal for Ghana, goal to be good. Niger need to fight back. He started well, and now they're trailing.
And that's a good response from Niger, and Ghana need to tune in quickly. So often in big games, it's said that teams are vulnerable when they've just scored themselves. So Ghana have got to disprove that theory. Be on their toes here. Confirmation of the change.
He's been playing through the pen barrier, Kofi Dankwa. But I was thinking the Tenko team should have assessed the injury situation and perhaps rested him.
Victorian's corner, not his best. And that's fired wide.
Moussa Dauda Youssef, the man who played for Proud United and was the captain. He knows Ghana in and out.
Knows this fella's power in the air inside out. One back by Kobina. The captain Twum to Frimpong. Kizito on the charge again. Now he's got a new opponent, direct opponent, in the shape of Ibrahim. And a new centre-back partner for this man, Adumo.
Well, I think, I'm afraid for Niger, they don't have the solid centre-back role there. Mansour is a makeshift. Dankwa has played all through the game.
Kobina showing those fancy touches again. That's brilliant by him. The flag is up. That would have been something really special as he lifted it somehow into the path of Stephen Sarfo. But when he gets on his game, Winfell Kobina, he's got a wand of a left foot and he nearly worked some magic there.
He always would have the magic wand, wouldn't he? There's a man to look out for anytime he's playing the playmaker for the Black Stars. The Ghanaians love to have him in the game. When he gets his A game, I did say early on, Ghana gets going. If he doesn't, everything falls flat.
Yes, but when they're on song, there's a lovely balance about the front end of this Ghana side. Sarfo and Kizito, one playing behind the other, that works quite well. Kobina just drifting in from either flank. There goes Sarfo. The downside with Kobina, he can switch off, and he coasted there for a moment and he was caught. Happily for Ghana, it didn't work out into anything for Niger as Honey Koi gave chase.
Flag up on offside against Kizito, but an interesting aspect of the game which you're seeing that the Ghanaians are having some bit of difficulties on the left flank there because Thomas Abi is not joining the attack because of Victorian Adebayo.
Dauda. Foul on Babubakar. Time for everybody to take a deep breath if you're supporting Niger, but the Ghana crowd here just stoking it up more and more and more.
Anytime the Black Stars go up, they win the game. When they concede, they lose it. They're up by a goal to nil. It could be a winning turn for Ghana.
Layoff by Hinsa. Gets it back from his left back. Kaido. Ibrahima. Adamu. Strokes it out to Lebne. Dela. Side to side, Niger go. Now looking to play down the outside of Frimpong. Kobina. Lando sprints out there. Little slow to react.
Good ball, watch this one. No more take with the assist.
And you know what else? Lebne is the player who plays him onside. If he doesn't drop back onto the line here, Safo would have to be given offside.
Yeah, so Lebne was in the wrong place at the time when the ball was hooked in. Look at it,